hello, everybody. H-L-Wow.
H-L-Wow.
Today we are Mitchell here and Kevin as well. We are doing some post-commentary on Super Smash Bros. For Wii U.
Got him. We have Mitchell here playing the young Rob, and I'm going to be playing Cloud.
Yes, I think we've said, but this is not live. This is going to be a post-commentary after the fact.
That we did, that we were destroying each other. Yep. Me and Mitchell, pretty even at this game, to be honest. So what's your thought process coming into this game? What do you think the matchup's
going to
be
like? Both of us play different styles of combat. We have you, who plays a very wait-and-see style, with a lot of shield grabs, a lot of running back and forth, waiting, more watching your opponent. Whereas me, I would say I have more of a machine gun style, kind of just constantly attacking and trying to get the opponent into an advantageous position for combos.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that. I mean, I play a lot more defensive style. Yeah, you see a lot of, like right now currently, you just see a lot, what Mitchell's doing is gyro, laser, does a little down smash, and then, see there's another down smash, and then does a lot of neutral airs just like that to cover.
That was a good beat.
That was a great cross slash. Didn't kill, unfortunately. Didn't have really rage there, so. But basically, what I'm trying to do is just trying to wall out. Ooh, really good down smash by me. That was, I just punished your took a neutral air right there.
Took an early lead in the stocks.
Yeah. That's really, really important for the Cloud matchup, too. Also, I mean, I get heavier when I have Limon on, so it's going to be a lot harder to kill me. I'm just kind of spot dodge standing there, because usually at the... And I just... Okay, good. I thought I just suicided right there, and I was like, wait a minute, what?
He's like, well, hold on there.
The power of Limit Up B, people. The power of Limit Up
B. See, a lot of shield grabs.
Yeah, a lot of shield grabs. Unfortunately, Cloud doesn't have very good at combos when it comes to just coming to up air. Oh, okay. You
got
did
you with the last hit. The last hit, that's all that matters. The others are just icing on the cake.
And then, you're trying to frame trap me with that gyro thing. Good jabs by me. Yes. Right now, I have quite a lead on you. So I can't remember what the outcome of this is going to be.
I just got to kill you at this point.
Yeah,
because right now, all those, you missed with the B-side. I missed with the up smash.
Oh, that was a good smash dab by you. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but I down smashed him and he actually got out of it. So,
I tried to grab you at the exact moment you tried to down smash me. So we just cancel each other. Finally got the stock off,
but I mean, Rob with rage is pretty scary, though. It's pretty easy for... Oh, well, that was a really good combo. He's basically kind of like tripped me with gyro right there, actually.
Yeah, rolled right into it.
Yeah, good down smash, dude. I'm spamming a down smash a lot this time. If you didn't notice, though, if you saw the up B's from Mitchell, he is a Rob main. So I'm not really a Cloud main, but I'm trying to pick him up as a secondary. And why don't you tell people how you're doing that up B
thing. What you do for normally for Rob, that move.
See that move when he's like flailing his arms. Basically.
Yeah, what you do is normally you just hold B up, or really just hold the B button, and Rob will continue flying upwards. But when you are pushing the up B, when you push up B once, Rob cannot do anything else until he lands. So what you do is you can just that was a nice kill by you.
You just read your roll right there.
Yes, but until Rob lands, he can't do anything else except up B. But he only uses the fuel when you press B button. So what you do is you literally can button spam B, and he keeps the momentum from pushing up, but he isn't constantly using it. So you can effectively double your vertical recovery by just pressing B over and over again instead of just holding it down.
So okay, yeah, so that's pretty interesting. Basically, your recovery time is doubled, so it's a good tech skill to know.
Yeah, you can really use that to help, as long as if someone spikes you and it doesn't just flat out auto-kill you, you can use that to pretty much recover from anything when it comes to down. And I don't know if it actually helps, but I figured out using back air when you're off the edge gives you some forward momentum as well. So
oh,
I
really
use that to get closer to the edge sometimes.
See, I didn't even know that. So.
Yeah, it's a little experiment I'm working on. I don't know if it actually helps, but I do that when I'm coming back to the edge.
So now, see, I have the percentage lead again. It's pretty much how this matchup goes, I would think. Cloud was second best character in the game now?
Yeah, I would say
best character
pretty
in the game.
Close. Right now, I think the best is actually Diddy Kong again.
Yeah, Diddy Kong again. After, three nerfs now it's been?
Yeah,
but he's still a tier 1.
He's back up top again.
Yeah, really high tier character. But you seem to be holding your own pretty well here, too. You did, two frame traps right there. Good grab by you, good grab.
Yep, not able to get the up air, but you got that dodging for it down.
He's still
Rob does really well on platform stages because all of his air moves are really quick, like the up tilts and stuff like that.
Basically right here, What's basically happening is I'm just trying to get a good. What I was trying to do is get a good cross slash. Let's see, does he read my air dodge? Oh, that was a good down air by me, and good up air. I'm gonna clean the sack right there. Pretty high percentage though. Basically up grab, which you were just trying to go for, but good down smash. Good down smash. That was a good down smash. All
right. Yep. Where it's basically a nice even game right here. Can go either way.
Yeah, pretty much could go either way. Basically, if you guys notice right now, the one flaw that Clout has is, oh god, yeah.
And
basically,
Lylatted.
Well, I got Lylatted right there. Unfortunate, but to be honest though, when I'm really looking at that, even if I did try to go up there, if I didn't sweet spot that, you would have spiked me and I would have died anyways. So
yeah,
that was a pretty rough game right there for me. I mean, You just clouded me, basically. Cloud has one of the worst recoveries in the game.
He has no horizontal recovery whatsoever. And he doesn't even have that good of vertical recovery unless he has the fully charged...
Limit break.
But you really don't want to be using it on that.
Yeah, you want to use it on cross slash. That is the most... Not Cloud main, but he is my secondary, I would say.
Ooh, nice trip there.
That was a good trip from the down tilt. Gets a good 26% off that, so it's pretty worth, I would say. Anyways, as I was saying, Cloud, you want to use your limit for cross slash, because with cross slash it kills, I would say, at least like 80 or 90 depending on the weight class. And if you use it just to recover, you're not using it up to its full potential. Basically, right now, if you want to do as we play Cloud, is you want to try to get as much aerial mobility as possible, because his up air is, I would say, the best up air in the entire game. It does what, like 12% for one move.
It's literally crazy.
It's like
super fast too. Oh man!
I was trying to see if you were gonna just run at me and then grab me right there, because you've been doing that a lot. As I said, bad recovery. I mean, you just basically get me off the stage right there. So really close game. Now I need to finish off the stock basically. Good job by me. Roll behind and jab.
At this point,
you.
I'm just have icing on the cake. Just need to survive and deal damage.
Try to get that extra credit basically. If you notice there too, a good thing to do at the mid 50% of the Cloud too is if you notice I've been doing a lot of neutral airs, because I've been noticing as a reactive player, which I am, Mitchell has been, I was waiting for you to new move there, just to try to up air you right there, but anyways, going through my thought process again, I'm trying to use neutral air to cancel out your neutral air, but that strategy is not really working that well, so now I'm trying to do back air strats. It seems, but yeah. I just need to try to wait you out.
Yeah, I'm trying to do, because one thing that I still don't have completely down with Rob, and it does result in me getting shield grabbed a lot, is I need to space out my neutral A's a little bit more.
Yeah.
Because I need to hit, nice move.
There's a cross slash.
Need to hit the neutral air in midair and then have it back off at the end of it so that I'm not in grab range. Nice prediction on the forward smash.
That was a good roll read. All right, I have limit though, so we're good. Oh, dude, if that would have hit you right there, that would have been perfect, because I could have actually tried to gimp you right there, but upper's not gonna kill. No rage, no rage, so we're not gonna
die.
No
damage.
Yeah, he has freaking, you have no damage there, so. Yes, he has, the only problem with neutral air is it does a lot of damage. 7 damage for an aerial is pretty good, but it just doesn't have any knockback, so yeah, it can combo into itself. Oh, those are good jabs.
I have the gyro.
Basically, now all he needs to do is grab me, which, he was just about to. He was just about to right there, and then it's over pretty much. But pretty sure this game is over unless I, like, pull a miracle out of my ass, which it's happened a couple times. But
yeah, it has.
I doubt it. Good down tilt. Down tilt's really, really good, too. It annoys you, too, so much when I play with Cloud. Because it, like, gets around all of your lasers and crap like that.
That slide is really nice. A lot of down tilts don't move. Only very few characters have down tilts. Oh, nice.
That was good.
I'm expecting another jab.
Yeah,
jab.
Well, what I was really looking there for was you did jab again, and then I thought you were going to go and grab me because that was the easier thing, but you just like, knew that you was going to spot dodge, so then he just read me.
Yep, that's the end of the match right
so
there.
So point one for Mitchell right here. So now he's going to go, you're going to play your secondary main.
Yep, this is my secondary player, Corrin. As soon as Corrin came out, I just loved that it was a dragon player, and she's orange.
So. Yeah, she is orange, which is, by the way, if you guys didn't know, if you're new here, orange is Mitchell's favorite color.
Yeah, so as soon as I saw a good character that was orange, it was really nice. Corrin is very interesting. She has a lot of moves that people don't think could really, she has a mechanic in the game, like that move right there, a mechanic in the game that no other character has, and she has her B sideways spike, which can pin people to the ground, and then you can go off of literally four different things out of it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you can go out of the forward kick. You can do a roundhouse kick and go around to the back. You can jump out of it. Or you can literally just do nothing and then just flop down on the ground.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so... Oh, technically a fifth thing, because if you're going into a horizontal... If you're going up to a horizontal wall, like, let's say... I don't know... the game map, the Wario map, the one that gives you map that has sideways walls all the way down, you can use the you can use that spike move to stick into the wall and act as an extra jump for recovery.
So like an extra recovery move, yeah.
Yes.
Right here what I'm doing is, oh man, I shouldn't need right there. But, Cam Falcon, he used to be my secondary, I would say Cloud now is my main character, I keep saying secondaries, is Ness, but I don't think I play him here. Do I play him?
No, you didn't.
Yeah, see, I didn't play him here, but I'm just trying to practice with my secondaries, so I have, like, you know, pocket picks. But basically, ooh, good back air by me.
Yeah, that was good back air.
Just basically read his jump there, so nothing too special, but it was just mainly a read. What you want to try to do is, when I play Captain Falcon, is I like to do guaranteed safety combos. I can't believe I just pummeled you guys when you had 17 damage. A little cocky right there. But you gotta be cocky when you're a Falcon player, though. You gotta risk it for the biscuit, in my opinion. Because if you don't, people like Korn, for example, all of her moves do more damage than yours. So you just gotta try to go for good reads and stuff like that. And I think one of Falcon's best moves is actually Jab. It comes out so fast. I think it's like frame 2. And it does... I would say good 10 damage. Ooh,
yeah.
Good be sideways, buddy. That's be sideways.
A lot
right?
of
yeah.
the all any move that Korin has that has a spear on it, the very tip of the spear is a sweet spot. So
it's like the Marth.
Yeah, it's exactly like Marth's tippers. So exactly, yeah. If you can aim those perfectly, one of the things that's really good for Korin, especially on this stage, is you can run off of those second platforms and immediately do a B sideways, and you can get a really easy tipper on someone that's on the ground.
Yeah. I think my favorite combo with Falcon is just running grab. Oh, that was a great read by me.
Yeah,
right
I tried
there.
To get the tipper as well, Ooh. But I missed.
Ooh, man, that's dirty. So as I said, you know, Falcon is a riskier character, I would say, than Cloud, 100%. But sometimes you can get really early kills. Like, I killed you at 70 there, I think.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that is crazy. So... And my favorite combo, I think, with Falcon is just running up, grab, and then doing up air into another up air is really, really good. Just like 25 damage or something. So for grab counts, it's pretty
my
good.
My favorite combo with Korin is, especially in early percentages, like doing this. Oh, see if I can get it.
Oh, wait.
You see what I'm trying
to do. Yeah, I know. Trying to do the up tilt thing.
Yeah, A down. Yeah, down tilt. Oh, they countered each other.
Yeah.
And A down into up airs. And you can get like two or three up airs and just go straight into, up tilts into up airs. And that is so quick that even if they like are able to like shield it or something, you can just get them right in another one because it's so quick.
Ooh, oh, my shield almost died.
Yeah,
right there.
That's another unique move that Korin has. Her B attack not only shoots out a move similar to, I know there's another character, Zero Suit Samus's gun.
Oh, yeah, the laser
stun,
thing, yeah.
But it also has a chomping mouth on it that you can charge up individually. You can either have them both come out immediately, both be full charged, bring out the gun full charge and the mouth immediately, or bring out the gun immediately and the mouth full charge,
yeah.
Depending on the situation.
And that was really, I mean, if I just had a little less shield there, you probably would have killed me, to be honest.
Yeah, that mouth can kill at really high percentages, at really low percentages if you charge it up. That's one of my favorite ways of getting people off stage is as soon as they try to climb up, I stun them with a quick gun and then just get them with a full charge chomp, and it just kills them immediately.
If you notice, you just kind of, with Falcon, too, if we're going to talk about, like, the benefits and strengths of the characters, Falcon has one of the best running speeds in the game. He's very, very fast. I think he's like the third fastest character
Definitely
or something like that.
There.
He is up there. So don't quote me on that. But I know he is very, very fast. Back grab? Nah, it's not going to kill you. Fortunately, not Ness back grab. But you have to use your character's strengths. So Falcon, he has really, really good running speed. So typically when I play Falcon, I just charge at you, try to grab you, or do dash attack to start a combo. Because those are, I think, his two best combo moves. His best kill move, I think, is... Ooh, tried to get me there.
Yeah, I tried to get you with that exact combo I was talking about earlier.
His safest kill move, I would say, is just back air. That thing is just dirty. So,
If I had gone through a forward kick there, I might have actually killed you.
Yeah, maybe.
because the back kick doesn't have as it has more reach, but it doesn't actually do as much back. What's it called? The knockback. Oh, canceled your Raptor booster with my jab.
Raptor boost is another. It's a riskier option to kill, but it is still a good option. What I like to do is I like to just. If I know they're probably going to shield, we are at like freaking 150%. Yeah. So, but basically, all I like to do is, there you go. See, back air. It's really, really good.
High percentage is you just do the back air.
Yeah, it's really, really good. Oh, right into my mittens right there. That's another combo that's really, really good too is down grabbing the neutral air into neutral, depending on
their DM. My combo.
Oh, there it comes. Yeah,
even if you are able to spot air dodge out of it, just get you right back in it again. Yeah. It's really quick and can get you a good 50, 60%.
Yeah, you basically, that's the power of the DLC characters.
I know,
basically.
Right? Pay to win.
Pay to win, but not really, though.
Korn's definitely a good B tier character.
Yeah, she.
Higher tier than Rob.
Yeah.
But even though I'm 100%. Better with Rob.
I would say, like, the characters that we're playing are both pretty much even tiers, to be honest.
I would say yours is probably like good lower A tier.
Really?
Yeah, I would say Captain Falcon's higher than Corrin.
Really?
Yeah.
Probably because of just how fast he is.
Yeah, any characters that are super fast
are
really,
really good
in this game.
That's because they can punish slow characters a lot easier and can rack up damage. But Falcon also has a lot of killing power too.
There are basically two qualities in this game that make your character really good. Are they fast and how good is their air game?
Yeah.
Air game in this game is really powerful.
I would actually kind of have to disagree with you on that. I think, personally, that... Well, I agree with the speed. If you have a fast character, you're going to find success, basically.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh,
there's
the chomp, basically. Stun me, and then just chomp me. So you won game two right there, because the young chomp.
Yep.
And then, basically, with me, I think speed... If you ask any really, like, talented slash Smash player... I almost said slash player. Any talented Smash player, basically speed is probably going to be the number one thing on their list. If you have speed, you can bring out combos. So, and then the second thing is, I would say if they have a good grab game. If they have a good grab game, then it's really, really, really good. You know what I mean?
Yeah, pretty much.
So.
Yep. All right, hold on one moment, everyone. What I was trying to do is trying to bring up two of them, so I could just immediately play into the next one right after this one ended. Because we have like a, because for some reason we split it up into two videos.
Oh really?
Yeah. See if I can bring it up in a second one.
Okay.
I can just bring it up real quick right afterwards. And did we get into the second part already of the game of this one?
I'm pretty sure. Just start this one.
Okay.
Because we started the first. All right.
All right, we're starting here again. Sorry about that.
The technical difficulties. Probably just edited it out, to be honest.
Yeah, pretty much. All right, so here we have both players. What do you think about Duck Hunt as a map? Who do you think it benefits more, Corrin or Captain Falcon?
I think, that's a tough decision. Why you got to do this to me, Michelle? I would say Corrin actually probably has the advantage here, only because I think that this stage is actually the best for Ness.
Oh jeez.
And the whole reason why I think Corrin benefits from it is because since the blast zones are so low and you have such a good range with your forward smash, like that, right? See what I'm talking about? So basically,
the edges are really close.
Yeah,
to the
they're
stage
really
itself.
Close. So I think Corrin just has the advantage here. But the good thing is it's on basically there's not really that many platforms. So I can combo better, I would say, but you can kill me faster, so it kind of balances out, but I still think that Corrin has a slight edge. What about you? What do you think?
I would have to agree with that. The fact that there aren't any platforms, that many platforms, does help you, because Captain Falcon really likes fighting on a flat stage, so he doesn't have to worry about you other characters hiding on a platform.
Camping them out, basically.
Yeah, camping out, yeah. You can get easier back airs at higher percentages.
Yeah.
And plus the fact that this stage has flat bottoms, so even if I can't get the vertical recovery, I can just use the B sideways to stick into the wall and get some extra vertical recovery.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think it's like, you know, huge deficit.
No, I
don't. But it is still worth mentioning. Holy crap, dude, you're destroying me this game. Dude, I can't even get a stock off. Dude, you're going in deep. That's, I think, another good thing, too, is Camp Fong's recovery is pretty lacking. It's pretty telegraphed, too, whereas with Corrin's is a lot better. I think they made most of the new characters better. That was a good read by the dash attack, but Doesn't really matter. Oh, there you go. Up
there you get it.
So.
And now we're just going into a joke match.
We're going into a joke match.
You're playing. Who are you playing? So you won the second match too.
I did.
What a dick.
We were playing my Yoshi versus your Rob.
Yeah.
He picked up Rob after watching me play just because it looked fun.
And the only reason why I played Rob, and I'm actually pretty decent with Rob, unless I get wrecked here, which is a possibility. But I'm only decent with Rob because you play Rob. That is literally the only reason. Because, like, you know, I've played against Mitchell's Rob so many times that, you know, it's just kind of muscle memory. I use a gyro a lot more than you, though. Notice that.
You don't use a lot more of the machine gun style.
Yeah.
You pretty much just will spam the gyro and stuff like that. And
yeah.
If the gyro goes away, so you just bring it out again. A lot of close range gyros.
Yeah.
Not a lot of jumps for them, not using them a lot.
Ooh,
for...
That was good.
What's it called? Keep getting back on the keeping people off the stage. You pretty much just spam it on stage and just spam the same gyro over and over again.
Yeah, basically. Just try to keep you away as much as possible.
And just
so see, I'm using it so much that, you know, I even like do the fake up thing. Oh, see, I was trying to wait for you because I thought you were gonna air dodge, but that didn't work out. But basically, I think one of the funniest things about your Yoshi is there's a move that. When we first started really playing and picking up the game, Mitchell was playing Yoshi, and I can't remember who I was playing. I was playing, like, Donkey Kong or some a bad character, basically. Not saying Donkey Kong's bad, but, like, a heavyweight, and it's slow. And I remember you were just like, all right, I'm going to short hop jump, and then I'm going to use down air.
Yeah.
And down Yoshi's air. Down air has this stupid property where if you're, like, a slow-ish character, like, Rob is... He's, like, medium speed, so I shouldn't just say slow, but, like, a medium to slow speed character that has big hitboxes, Yoshi's down air just destroys their shield. I think you broke my shield, like, 3 times one time or something like that.
It
I was
literally
like, why?
Shreds shield. It's like, that's a nice shield you got there. It'd be a shame if something happened to it.
Yeah, like, right there, when you were just using down air right there, you only hit me, like, 3 times or whatever.
Like, half your shield.
Half my shield's gone, so it's a really, really good move.
Yeah, unfortunately, it leaves you very vulnerable afterwards, but if you can get it. I'm still also working on the spacing of the forward air like that.
Yeah,
I keep trying to spam, because I love using that move.
If you really noticed, Mitchell likes to, at least what I notice when I play him all the time, is you jump, then you fade away, then you go back in, then you use an aerial. So, like, for example, for Rob, you would jump, use neutral air, and fade away. Just kind of like what you're doing with Yoshi. You know what I mean?
Trying to do it with Yoshi.
Kind
of got it backwards.
Whoa, I almost died right there. Thank God.
If I would have gone in and tried to do like a back air, and I could have done a space. I could have potentially
stage
got a stage
me.
Bike.
Yeah,
you
know? I could have. If I didn't tech. Yeah. But basically that Mitchell.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah,
if I can get
it
that perfect distance.
Because then that way I can't shield grab you there. Yeah.
Right.
See, he's starting to get the hang of it now, but it's a lot easier to punish a movement like that when you're shield grab. But, get dumpstered.
Spike.
I just got dunked on, basically.
Yeah.
Good spike by you.
Yeah. Still working.
Props.
He's only I'd say he's probably like my third.
Is he?
Yeah, there's not really anyone. The only other person I really play are either Bowser or Ganondorf.
Ganondorf. I think we only play Ganondorf because he's. If you've ever paid attention to history of Smash, Ganondorf has been bad throughout every Smash, like, ever in existence, except for, like, Project M, but, you know, we can't really count that, so, I remember we were, like, playing Ganondorf mirrors or whatever, just to make sure that, you know, it was just for funsies, basically.
Basically. I would like to go into a big tournament and just, like, wreck everyone with Ganondorf.
Yeah.
That would be so
good. Cool. Luck, dude, good luck. I wish you luck on your journey. Oh, God. Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, that move
that
can send you down.
Me. I was like, ugh.
It doesn't spike, though. It can just send you down, but unfortunately, the only move that Yoshi has that spikes is his forward air.
Yeah, I mean, Yoshi has a really good frame data, though, so.
Yeah. The one thing I also like about Yoshi is that his second jump has super armor.
So you can get out
of combos just by jumping.
Just by hitting X or Y, you can... Well, we play on the GameCube controller, so...
Just by hitting the jump button,
yeah,
you
just
can
by
just
hitting
get
the
out
jump
of
button.
A lot of combos.
Ooh, that was a good get-up attack by me.
Yeah, I was expecting a roll.
Really?
Yeah,
I know.
Because you like to stay back and just fire gyros.
Yeah. I'm a very defensive player, and then I just... As Mitchell was saying, I'm a wait-and-see kind of player, so It's like, I see you do a move, and if you screw up, I just go in for the punish, basically. I'm a very punish-heavy character, very punish-heavy player, I should say. So, good down smash by me. You're probably still gonna survive. Yeah. Those double jumps, though.
Yeah, I'm not a player who likes to wait and see what the opponent does very often. I'm more of, what can I do to get you where I want you to go?
And then I'm going to combo the crap out of you, basically.
Yes.
Hey, oh, that was a good answer, just death. Anyways, but, yeah, I'm basically the exact opposite playing style. And that's really, really good for us, because I would say, to be honest, I think when I do play Ness, though, who is my main character, I am a little bit more aggro, but not by much. If I'm playing, like, Rob or anyone with a projectile, I'm going to just, you know, spam the crap out of it. And the good thing about Gyro, I don't know if you know this, but you probably do because you're a Rob main. But with Gyro and Banana, what Diddy Kong has, those two items, no matter how much you use them, they will never decrease in damage, ever. They never get stale. And for those of you who don't know what staling moves means, here, Mitchell can explain.
Yeah, if you spam a move too much in the game, that was a nice up smash.
Yeah, that was a good up smash.
If you spam a move too much in the game starts punishing you by making the move weaker and weaker the more times you use it.
Yeah, not just in damage, but in knockback as well, correct?
Yeah, but since Rose moves are items, they're not technically you, so yeah. They don't get stale. Because the move always going to do the same amount of damage no matter how many times you hit with it.
That's the, yeah, and a lot of people, when I was doing a lot of Smash research, there's a lot of debate between what actually is the best move in the game. Is it Banana or is it Gyro? What do you think?
I honestly think that, oh, nice.
Ooh. And almost got you with the platform right there.
Yeah, that's one reason I really like Rob in the, or like those characters that do kind of up grabs in this area because of the fact that you can do up grabs onto the stages and it will give you some extra height. So that's one thing that can easily get a kill for you. But back to what we were saying, I honestly think that the banana peel is better.
Really?
Yeah, I'd say the banana peel is better because it does that little slip up. And that slip up, you can go. There's a reason Diddy Kong's number one right now. You can use the banana peel to get you into a combo, an easy up air into even a potential hoo ha.
Yeah, the hoo.
Just spamming the up air.
Yeah.
But Gyro, you can't really combo with it. The best thing that Gyro can do
is. You can frame trap people with it on the edge.
Yes, it's good at.
Gyroing on the edge is really, really good.
Yeah, it's good at gimping people and keeping them from getting back on the stage, but. On stage, it's really just a good damage dealer or knockback fuel.
I think it's really hard. I would actually probably. I think that the for. I think Gyro is much better as a move that damages.
Yeah.
Whereas with Banana, I would have to agree with you that Banana is better only because if you think about Gyro. You can do. It does more damage, and you can frame trap people on the edge really well. Oh, I thought I was gonna hit that down smash and kill you. But anyways, as I was saying, Gyro does more damage. Gyro also can frame trap on the edge really well. If you watch, I can't remember what his name is. He's a Rob main that plays Rob professionally.
I can't
remember what his name is, but he does. He's the one who invented all these frame traps at the end of the stage, you know, for recovery options. However, with Banana, the reason why I think it's better is because Banana is just so much more versatile. Like, it damages for 5 damage, I think. It trips you, so you can literally do. I'm Rob, so it doesn't matter.
Rob, probably would have killed him.
Yeah.
Nice footstool there.
Yeah.
Your footstool is when you still have a jump. You can press the jump button right when you're right on top of someone else, and it will cause them to footstool. And for a couple of seconds, they just fall and can't do anything, and that can easily get you killed.
Yeah.
It also can get you into some nice combos if you're on stage. But it's not extremely easy to do. Some characters can do it pretty easily.
Yeah, and the bigger the character, though.
Yeah, obviously.
Oh, you read that, but you just didn't do it as much time. But anyways, I was saying with the banana thing, it's more versatile. You can literally, when someone's tripped and prone, there's nothing they can do about it. You can literally do any move. Forward smash, up smash, any, like literally any move. Like, there is no item, or there's no, not item, there is no move in the game besides tripping, which is usually with down tilts. Like Rob's down tilt has, I don't know what the percentage is for.
Yeah, I don't know the percentage either.
But you know, some moves have the potential to trip, whereas Banana's guaranteed trip. And when you trip someone, it's basically you can do whatever you want. For me personally, I usually always just grab them. That was a good read on the ups, air dodge. Yeah. But I think it was 186 though, dude.
Yeah.
I was living. So, but I would have to agree with you. The only reason why though is I think for newer players, like if you're just like an average player, I think Gyro is better though.
Well, yeah,
because it just does more damage.
It's
you know?
More. It's not a combo enabler.
Yeah.
It's just a straight up damager, and you can use it to get people off the stage or keep people off.
Yeah. So I would say like for more advanced players, like I would consider us above. We're not like pro level, but I would say we're way above average. You know.
Yeah.
We're at that threshold where you know.
We can go to tournaments and do decent.
Yeah. We do decent.
Haven't won one in a while.
Really? I've won like two.
Yeah, but how recently?
It was like 2 months ago, I think.
Yeah, it's been a little bit that I've actually won one. I get in the top three every time.
Yeah, yeah, every time you get in the top three. Ah, oh, hey, I won one!
Yay!
I won a match! All right, guys. Is that almost the end?
Yep, yeah. That is it.
All right, guys. So, basically, that's the end of the video. My name's Kevin.
And this is Mitchell.
And I hope you guys see you in the next episode for HOI. All
right, see you later, guys.